Hey, sweet friends, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while since I've made a video, and I just wanted to give you guys an update on what's been happening. We've recently moved to a new house. The last house that we had was a rental, as well as this new house, but this new house we are really happy with. It's a lot bigger and spacious for us, which is a good thing since we are now expecting. As of right now, this video, I'll be 28 weeks pregnant, and we're really excited to meet our little girl that's going to be coming in February. So that's what's been going on. Just been really busy making sure that the house is put together and really taking my time to enjoy this season of pregnancy with the girls, slowing things down a bit. But I'm very happy to be back here.
When I can't seem to carry on, I know your hand is guiding me. I know your hand is guiding me.
So today I thought I'd take you along with me to do some chores around the house and make a couple of yummy treats.
Through the valley I may walk, but you were all I'll ever need. Gave you life to take my fall, so in the storm I will have peace. So come the storm, I'll still believe.
So I've been making a lot of sourdough pancakes lately, and it's been really good for us to reset our gut. It's been a while since I made sourdough pancakes, and we're just jumping back into our rhythm again. It feels really nice. So these particular pancakes are going to be berry pancakes, and what's great about the berry pancakes is that it's already sweet from the berries. Later I am going to top it off with a little bit of powdered sugar instead of maple syrup because it's already going to be sweet from the fruits that we put in.
Rainy days don't seem so wet. Stormy nights don't stay.
Aside from the berry pancakes, me and the girls have been enjoying banana pancakes too, which bananas are sweet as well. So you don't have to put any maple syrup, just a little bit of powdered sugar, and you're good to go.
The best thing that I'll ever know. Talk for hours and never slept. Two silhouettes on the concrete steps. We watched the sun as it slowly crept from the horizon to the place we met. Oh, this could be the best thing that I'll ever know.
So one thing that I'm really excited about with this new house is the laundry room. The last house, if you guys can remember, had the laundry in the kitchen and then the dryer in the garage. So it was just, the flow wasn't easy This new house has the washer and dryer in one place, which makes it so much easier for me, and I can keep everything tidy in one area. So my mom bought me this bread machine, and I have been using it to help me proof my sourdough doughs. So I'm going to be making sourdough bread machine bagels. So you put all the ingredients in, and you leave it overnight, and it mixes it and ferments it for you. And then the next morning, it should be all ready to bake.
I tried my best, I'd like to say, Jesus, please hold on, when I simply don't have a song, and my heart can't give you praise, it doesn't care to even sing.
So the next morning, the dough is ready to fold and shape into bagel shapes. And here, I believe I was able to make 8 bagels with this dough recipe. There is a second proof for this recipe, but it's just for an hour. And while that is proofing under the damp towels, you can boil the water with a little bit of brown sugar, and then that will help it bake up really well. And so I just set the bagel dough in the hot water just for a little bit, so it doesn't get too like gummy after it bakes in the oven. But if you like it that way, then you can leave it in for a little bit longer. Thank you. thank you for being here with me today, friends. I really appreciate everyone that has checked up on me and stuck around. If you like this content, please subscribe, like, and say hello in the comments, and I'll see you next Sunday. Bye.